Warning. Stand by for countdown. Prepare audience for maximum impact. Full immersion begins in.
My black people, it's all about the unity. There's nothing they can do with us, so ain't nobody move for me.
I'm a soul man,
no.
I'm a soul man.
Yes, I am.
I'm a soul man. I'm a soul man, love.
You couldn't be so. You couldn't be so. You couldn't be so.
They see something that I don't see. What can you learn from a bum, Omar? Amsterdam? What I learned from a bum, maybe it's what not to do.
Up 7 easy. There's a reason why after 100 channels destroyed, Angel Snuffin' Up 7 is still here. There's a reason, but you don't take me seriously.
Thank you.
don't care about the people. But Angel Snuff Number 7 cares about the people because I'm bold enough to tell you the truth, and I don't give a damn if you give me a dime. I'm not looking for your money.
We are in a state of emergency.
Prejudice. Wrote a song about it? Like to hear it? Here it go.
Free your mind.
This is a story about control. My control. Control of what I say and control of what I do. And this time, I'm gonna do it my way. I hope you enjoy this as much as I do. Are we ready? I am, because it's all about control, and I've got lots of it.
I can't describe all the joy that I feel.
In the name of my ancestors, peace forever and always, and welcome to another edition of what we call the Realities Temple on Earth Internet Ministry. I am the gatekeeper or the host of this program, known here on social media. Wherever you may find me, I am known as the mighty, mighty, mighty Angel Snuff Number 7. I am your soul brother, number one. It is not my intent to be here very long. I just wanted to put my little two cents in and go on about my business. Thank you for joining us on this spontaneous broadcast after the debate between Kamala Harris and Donald J. Trump from last night. We are simulcasting on Facebook and all the Facebook channels in affiliation with Realities Temple on Earth Internet Ministry. On Facebook, we are broadcasting on Realities Temple on Earth YouTube channel, Realities Temple on Earth Angel Snuffin' Up 7 YouTube channel, and Realities Temple on Earth Internet Ministry YouTube channel. Woo! And we want to add Rumble. As soon as Rumble becomes free. All right, let's get this party started. Let's make these points and get out of here. I could be wrong. I always tell people I could be in error. So I'm not saying that I'm right about anything. Unlike some of you, you are right. I do not base my decisions or my opinions based upon emotion. We must base our conclusions on facts. And we must choose what is in our best interest, not because of something that we hear that make us feel good. Because a poor man, you can't eat because somebody says something that feel good. Somebody got to produce something to put in your belly. Somebody has to produce something so that you can lay down on a pillow at night. Feeling good does not help you. But there are a lot of people in this country who feel good. So they're not listening for a message to fill their belly, because my belly is already full. I already eat. I want somebody to make me feel good, regardless to the consequence. Because I'm comfortable and I feel good. Support this fairy tale that we want to see, instead of the reality of what we face. I'm not a politician, but we offer a vision called, where is it, on this side? The Mississippi Campaign, which is based in politics, but it is neither Republican or Democrat. In fact, you can form your own party. But if I had to, what they say, what's that old saying? Choosing between two evils. If I had to choose between the two evils, or between the two rotten apples or the two rotten bananas, I guess I would choose Donald Trump. The best of the two evils, the best of the rotten potatoes, the better tasting of the rotten meal. Why would you say that? I could change my mind. We can do that. We can change our mind. Most people, when they vote based on emotion. They don't really vote upon the facts. They don't really based upon the character, and they really don't understand leadership skills. They vote and they support based on emotional rhetoric. Who you like and who you don't like. Leadership should not be based upon a popularity contest. That is the reason why the popular vote does not count. The presidency is based upon the electoral college. This whole thing reminds me of when Hillary Clinton was running for president. And she was so hyped up. You're going to be the first woman president, and she did win the popular vote. The vote that wins the presidency is based upon the Electoral College, because the founding fathers of this nation understood that the population basically was illiterate, in no position to choose a leader. So they give you the illusion of being part of the process, but you're not. All these polls really don't mean nothing. It is what is on the mind of those who are part of the Electoral College, who we don't know nothing about. Who are they? You should want to know who is the Electoral College. Who are these people that are actually the ones voting for your president? But all of you already know that, right? So I'm looking at this unbiased. If you can bring me something that make me view Kamala Harris differently, I'm open-minded. Because I'm choosing, I already know, and most of us know, we're choosing between two evils. Always somebody rich. Always somebody rich that we vote for. Never nobody that comes from where the average person comes from. So what do they know about the people? They always talk about, I heard Kamala Harris talk about the people, the American people. The American people are middle class. The majority of the American people are poor. What do you know? Because once you leave, you don't think about no poor people no more. You don't think about no middle class no more. You are with those taking pictures, bragging about what you got. Look how I live. Look who I know. Taylor Swift endorsements. Who the hell is Taylor Swift? What the hell do she know? But this is how we think. So the forefathers, we're not going to put leadership in the hands of these illiterates. And so what does that tell you about your nation when the Electoral College is still electing your president? The government is still saying that you are a nation of illiterates and you're ignorant. You're too stupid to choose a president in 2024. And you don't question that. You don't talk about that. So all this hype going to the polls and you vote, that don't mean nothing. Maybe you can influence those who are part of the Electoral College. That's who you might try to, what we like. Because everything about us is based on emotion. That's why we treat politics the same way we do with religion. Our belief, it makes us feel good. You can go to church, singing, dancing, hooping, holler. That's what you do at these rallies. Go Trump, go. Go Kamala, go. Yeah. Hooping and hollering and dancing and singing. Bring on Oprah, an entertainer. Bring on Taylor Swift, an entertainer. Bring all these to entertain folks. You would think that those who are choosing the president of the United States, you would not be interested in entertainment. How are you going to lead me? Because just as Donald Trump said last night, the next leader could be leading us and the world into World War III. And the only thing you're thinking about is being feeling good. My commentary is based upon what I heard some of these persons in the news, their commentary. My commentary is based upon 20 minutes that I did watch the debate. And I was on a broadcast, my own live stream last night, and I was talking about, you know you're losing the debate when the person of whom you are debating keeps you on the offensive. And even those who support Kamala Harris, none of them are saying that she was not on the defensive. She was always on the offensive. She was always twiddling her thumbs, running around trying to think of an answer, because this man kept her on the offensive. He was always on the defensive. And most would agree upon that. So how the hell you gonna win a debate of which many of her supporters, it don't make any difference, Kamala won the debate. It don't make any difference. She could have looked like Biden. Oh, Kamala, she won the debate. But she didn't. You cannot win a debate staying on the offensive. There was no equality. The way those questions was brought gave her an advantage. And she still couldn't, because she's not like that. Let's talk about it. Get out of here. Let's talk about it. Those in the comment section, if I'm in error, correct me. Unlike some of these folks, I'm open to correction. But please make it make sense. Please make it make sense. Join the conversation. If you are on our Facebook channel, if you are here on Reality's Tip on Earth, Internet Ministry, YouTube channel, click the link, join the conversation. I got the time. Do you see what I see? Let's do this. In the title of my commentary of this video stream, I call Kamala Harris a trickster. A trickster, a deceiver. You're not being up and up. We're going to prove that. I'm going to show you. I'm going to show you why I say that. I saw her over and over again. We don't need division. We don't need division in this country. We don't need hate in this country. That's what she said. She kept doing that over and over again. We don't need trouble like this in our country. This man is divisive. That's what she said. Okay. So I would ask Kamala, I would ask Kamala, Where is your house in the ghetto, Kamala? That's one of the questions. Since America is so divided and Donald Trump is behind the division or causing some of the division in America, where is your house in the ghetto? You don't have one. America has always been divided. There's the Jewish community. There's the Asian community. There's the Ethiopian community. There's the German community. There's the rich community. There's the middle class. It's all about division. What you talking about, lady? There are those who commit murder and go home free. And then there are those with a traffic ticket go to jail for years. There is no justice for everybody in this country. There is no unification. You tell me, Kamala Harris, why is there an unusual amount of black men being shot down in the street by police? Why was there a Black Lives Matter, Miss Kamala? And you have done nothing about it. There is no united. America is not together like that. The division. How did Donald Trump divide or cause a division when it never was united? Here we are, soul brothers and sisters, the black man and woman in America. We have been separated on purpose for 400 years. We have to fight dogs and water hoses and all kinds of crap in order to be able to embrace the rights as a citizen that we were born with. Even right now, what is it, the Civil Rights Bill? It has to be voted on once every year or every other 2 years, however it is. We're the only citizens in this country that still has to vote. Somebody got to vote to give us rights to vote. Talk about that, Kamala Harris. If we're so together, why in the country history that we had to have a draft? If I'm a male, I should be happy to go fight for my country. But the draft, when they draft the poor and the middle class. And a lot of the rich, rich children don't go to the draft. They find a way to escape because we're not together. So you lie and you deceive and you put on this show like we're together. As a prosecutor for your own political self-enrichment, ma'am. I know, because I'm a victim of prosecutorial misconduct, injustice. Who knows how many men you done sent to prison to death row? And you know it might be a chance they're innocent. And you over-punish people so that you can go. I'm the top prosecutor. Look how many people I put in jail. Look how many people I put on death row. I know your kind, Kamala Harris. I had to deal with your kind for years and years and years. The Kamala Harris mentality. You don't want to talk about that. You don't want to talk about that, Miss Kamala Harris. I know your type. So one of her points, of course, is bringing up Donald Trump's conviction, which was a sham. I call it for what it is. Has nothing to do with whether I like Donald Trump. I know a sham because it happened to me. Even Judge Judy, the popular judge, she was asked about the trial, these trials, this legal stuff with Donald Trump. Under normal conditions, under normal conditions, they wouldn't bother with that crap. But these folks have a hatred for Donald Trump. There's a bias. Let's get them. Because they don't want to see him. He's unorthodox. He's unorthodox in the political system. He's not the regular politician. So let's use any tool, any way, anything that we can do to try to stop him. They have failed. That's dirty pool. It's no different than some of you that you don't like somebody. You will use your position as a judge, as a police officer, to hurt whoever you don't like. It's no different. And they do the same thing. They doing the same damn thing. I know when you're getting railroaded because it happened to me. Let's get Donald Trump. These prosecutors, let's bring charges against Michael Jackson. Let's bring charges against Trump. All this is a feather in my cap. It ain't about justice. It's about making a reputation so I can be president or the senator or the mayor. It's not about justice. Millions and millions of dollars used to go against, to try to put Trump in jail. What is the benefit? For what? Time wasted. And you have people, the Kamala Harris, you have American people in California living in cars. Some of them are doing it by choice, but there are many don't even have a car. All over the country, you have homeless people, and you're spending money trying to put this man in jail. Here we are spending billions of dollars for rich people to become president of the United States. That don't even make any sense. And nobody is crying about that. Billions of dollars to become president for rich folks, for somebody who are already rich to become president of the United States. It don't make any sense. It don't make any sense. Kamala needs to answer those questions. That's a sham trial. Talk about division. Oh, we need to break. What about, I already mentioned slavery. You want to call Donald Trump a convicted felon, but you live in a nation that denied women their rights for who knows how long, what, over 200 years? You lucky to be in the position that you're in. Women had to march. Women had to beg men, give me my rights, give me my rights. Black people still got to beg for it. They made slavery a way of life in this country. But Donald Trump is the convicted felon. He wasn't even born. He wasn't born when women were fighting in the beginning for their rights. He wasn't born when slavery was a way of life. This country is a damn felon. We talk about America like it's holy and righteous. When the hell did that happen? country, it accepts all kinds of filth and evil and wrong in this country. It accepts anything, everything. When the hell did the United States, they talk like the United States is Jesus Christ. This is not the Holy Land. Ain't nothing holy about the United States. And they don't, this nation don't accept responsibility for what it does. They make up excuses for the evil they do. And they hope that you forget. I am so happy for the brothers and sisters and those who believe in justice. I'm so happy that you raise your voice and don't let them forget. During the Vietnam War, these people murdered their own college students because they protested against the Vietnam War. What was the Vietnam War about? Trying to force those people to live like Americans so that you can exploit their natural resources. That's what Vietnam was about. And you killed and murdered your own children to try to do that. And the Vietnamese, thousands of them died. They held fast and they fought this evil, wicked regime and kicked them out of Vietnam. Just like they was kicked out of Afghanistan. Kamala Harris is just like anybody else doing these things for self-enrichment. She's no leader. She's just a follower. I'm listening to this woman. I don't hear nothing of leadership. I just hear a babbling parrot. I don't hear nothing. I don't hear nothing creative. I hear no vision. Just a bunch of dribble, fiddle daddle. If she sounded like she was really bringing leadership, being a prosecutor don't make you a leader. Here you're involved in the things that could cause the extreme death of American citizens. You are in a position that your activity and your actions, just like Donald Trump said, you could cause World War III. Let's talk about this and get out of here. There are many people who support Kamala Harris. You can come on the board. If I hear something that's different, I could be in error. I can accept that. I don't see it. The Trump conviction was a sham. The only reason why this is done because all these folks simply don't like him. Has nothing to do with justice. Sham trial. Kamala Harris brings up the Central Park Five. Here's a man, which he did. Here's a man that took out a full page ad to condemn these innocent boys. Nobody thought they was innocent. The majority of people did not think they was innocent. Here's a white woman. She was all messed up. And the city of New York believed the police like they usually do. There's a false thing in this country that you are innocent until proven guilty. I will bear witness because I'm a victim myself. You are guilty until you're proven innocent. When I was arrested, I was guilty. There was no assumption. And everything that came out of my mouth, I don't care if I said I want a Tootsie Roll. Whatever I said out of my mouth was used against me in a court of law. The police is your enemy. The prosecutor is your enemy. And sometimes even your public defender, your lawyer is your enemy. Because you are guilty until proven innocent. I know this from self-experience. So those boys, the city, not just Donald Trump, the city, a good majority of the people there, especially if you're white, if you're white, here's a Caucasian woman. How dare these black and brown children, what they did to this precious, innocent, white woman. They didn't give a damn. No different than the Jim Crow South. They done it. We don't care if they are boys. They in this country, they have electrocuted black boys, teenagers. They've given them the death penalty in this country because they did something to somebody white. Talk about it. Let's talk about it, Kamala Harris. It wasn't just Donald Trump. It was a lot of black folks, just like right now when somebody get murdered. There's a lot of black people. They deserve it. They deserve to get killed. It was their fault. Even though we know the history of the racism, police brutality in this country, it don't make no difference because you are guilty. The first thing that happened is, what did you do? Because you automatically believe the police. You automatically believe the president. When they talk about Osama bin Laden, oh, he must be guilty. They talk about, what's his name? Saddam Hussein, or whoever these leaders are. Vladimir Putin. They must be guilty. They're evil. They're wicked. Who is more evil and wicked than the nation that we're in right now? You need to put the United States on trial. Kamala Harris, I want to ask you something, Kamala Harris. Who was the mayor of New York City? I believe it was Koch. I'm not really sure. I believe it was Koch. I believe the Democrats ran New York City during the time of the Central Park Five. It was the Democratic Party. So it was the Democrats that happily condemned these boys. Then you look stupid when they find out that they're innocent. You know how folks are. Now you find out they're innocent. Now it's finger point. It wasn't me. I wouldn't do that. It wasn't me. Come on, Kamala. It was the Democrats that condemned them boys. The Democratic police chief, the mayor, all that was Democrats, wasn't it, Kamala Harris? Like they say, come talk to us. She's scared of other debates with this man. She did not want this debate. She's not a debater like that. She has no position. She's not a leader. She's a female Biden. She's nothing but a follower. She has no vision. She's not a leader. She was always on the defensive. She has no vision. She has no ideas. She kept going back to dividing of America. I want to ask you, Kamala Harris. What's a lobbyist? A lobbyist does not work for the people. The lobbyist works for special interest groups, for individuals, so they can get what they want from the president, from the Congress. The poor don't have a lobbyist. But we're supposed to be united. Donald Trump is dividing the country. You cannot divide something that never was together. This country has never been together. Everybody that comes to America is out for themselves. The white community does not give a damn about the black community. The Asian community does not give a damn about the black community. The German community don't give a damn about the Irish community. Everybody's out for themselves. These new immigrants coming across the border going to develop their own community and look out for themselves. So, brothers and sisters, black people are the only ones dumb enough to continue to believe in this melting pot fairy tale. And the Democratic Party made it very clear to these people that's pushing reparations. They made it very clear, even from somebody like, what's his name? Bernie Sanders. They made it very clear, we're not interested in giving you nothing. Give you some extra food stamps or something. We don't care how long your people suffered in this country. They're not giving you nothing. These are the type of folks that you put your hope and faith in. Because they didn't suffer Jim Crow. They always talk about slavery was a long time ago. What about Jim Crow? There's many people who suffered Jim Crow right now. I was born in Jim Crow. And say that was a long time ago. They don't want to give you nothing. These people have no character. They're not honest. They have no integrity. Do you understand? That's why I tell soul brothers and sisters, that's why I tell the black man and woman in this country, you better do something for yourself. And I'm not talking about all this tiddlywink stuff from 1930. Get on board the soul train. You need to develop this vision called Operation Exodus Mississippi campaign. That's your best option. If you don't do that, you might as well sit your ass down. Now, here we have somebody like Donald Trump. Ain't nobody perfect. You choosing between two evils. But during the presidency of Donald Trump, to my knowledge, he did pardon a lot of black folks in these jails and prisons. We watched Donald Trump talk to Ice Cube. Ice Cube had a proposal and he listened. Donald Trump talked to Kanye West and he listened. And we know that Kanye West was persecuted for his beliefs, for his ideology, for his words. Donald Trump listened to Kanye. Donald Trump listened to Ice Cube. Who did Biden listen to? Who black? Who do you know? Who do Kamala Harris and Biden, who did they listen to? Well, they listened to a little black woman. I give you a holiday. We'll give you June 10th. We want to celebrate that 2 years later, after you was free, you found out about it. That's what we want to celebrate. So let's make June 10th a national holiday, because we didn't tell the slaves they was free. Let's celebrate that. That's what Biden and Kamala Harris do. Kamala Harris kept telling Donald Trump, you're debating me, not Biden. You debating Kamala Harris. Okay, Miss Kamala Harris, lady. You are vice president. And you're trying to separate yourself from Joe Biden. Because I'm Kamala Harris. I'll do things my way. Okay. But you're the vice president. Now, when you're dealing with politics, when you're dealing with business, almost everything they do, you put on paper. That's why a lot of these companies get in trouble, because they send memos to each other. And then somebody find the memos, and that's proof, get them caught up, because that's how business, that's how politics work. They send memos to each other. They always write their activity, their ideas and their actions on paper, and they send it out. So if you're not like Joe Biden, Kamala, I'm going to say this, we're going to get out of here. If you're not like Joe Biden, Kamala Harris, then where is your memo asking him to stay out of the Israel-Hamas conflict, to stay out of the Ukraine? Where is your memos different from what Joe Biden does? She won't be able to show anything. Because you can be vice president, or you could be my son. And I'm going to do something. And my son said, Daddy, I wouldn't do that if I was you. But I'm going to do it anyway. Then when I get caught up, my son can honestly say, I told my daddy, don't do that. She's the vice president. Biden don't have to listen to her. But she can write in a memo. She can show how Biden wanted to do such and such, and she was against it. I was advising him, I would not do that if I was you. This woman support everything that Biden has done. She's no different. And I know a lot of the people that I've talked to who are Trump supporters, just based upon the economy. I mean, even you. You have to confess, and you have no choice. I remember, I love salmon. I love those salmon fillets. I was paying, during the Trump era, I was paying $4 to $5 for a nice slice of salmon. Now I'm paying, what, $5, $6 or more? Actually, it's more than that. Come to think of it. No, the last time I bought salmon, it was $8, $9, almost 10. When Trump was in office, I could get the same salmon slice for $5. It's doubled. The fish doubled. You was getting eggs for 99 cents when Trump was in office. Now some of y'all paying $3, $4 for a dozen eggs. This is facts. This is how we living when we talk about the economy. Donald Trump was not involved in wars. During Biden, you got the Gaza conflict. You got Ukraine. Who else knows what they're involved in? Exactly. Shout out to Nola. Exactly. There was a time that people was paying what $10, $15 for some eggs. Not too long ago. The bird flu had a lot to do with it also. But still, you still paying $3, $4. Some of us are paying $3, $4 for a dozen eggs during the Biden administration. The Biden administration gives welfare to everybody except the American citizens who Kamala Harris say, oh, we together. Don't let nobody divide us and then blah, blah, blah. But you're not doing nothing for the people. And she talking about we're going to give small business $50,000 loan. Why don't you just give them $50,000? Why can't be a grant, Kamala Harris? Why you just can't grant those that qualify, give them $50,000 to help them out? Why it's got to be a loan? Again, I could be in error. I'm talking out of ignorance. But you're going to have to deal with these points that I have made in this presentation. You're going to call Donald Trump a criminal. What about your nation and their involvement in the Tuskegee experiment, giving black men syphilis on purpose? What about that? That's not criminal, felon behavior, Kamala Harris. We need to talk. I want to hear both candidates. I want to hear both of them talk about why you believe that black people sold brothers and sisters, the descendants of slaves in America. I'm not talking about black immigrants. I'm talking about the real black citizens of this nation. Born and bred here for 400, on going on 500 years in this nation. You tell us, Donald Trump, you tell us, Kamala Harris, you tell us in our face why we don't deserve reparations. And we don't need no committee. We gonna set up a committee and talk about it. We don't need nobody to talk about a damn thing. Show me the money. I don't need no damn talk. This country know what you done to folks, to us in this nation. There's nothing to talk about. We've already talked about it. We've been talking about it since the end of the Civil War. They treat the black man and woman, the descendants of slaves in America, those who are victims of the descendants of Jim Crow, they talk to us like we stupid. Then you're gonna talk about how other countries mistreat their citizens, and look at you. The only reason why President Kennedy made a move was because of the television, and the whole world could see how this nation was treating their own citizens. So that's the only reason why Kennedy done something about it. The only reason. Black Lives Matter all over the earth. They could see how black folks are treated in this country. And those black folks with money don't give a damn about reparations, because I got my money. But the people that you come from deserve reparations, whether you have money or not. I could become a billionaire right now. I will use my billions to fight for reparations, because the people, not just me, the people, we as a people, the Black American, deserve reparation, the children, so we can repair ourselves from the damage that you caused. If you don't like Black people, you made us. Woo! A word almost slipped out my mouth. A word almost slipped out my mouth. I don't like deceivers. I don't like tricksters. These people smile in your face, stab you in the back. They don't give a damn about you. They nice. It's just like a man who just wants your panties, woman. He don't care nothing about you. Oh, you beautiful. I like you. That's a pretty dress. He don't care nothing about your pretty dress. He don't care nothing about your pretty hat. Only thing he care about getting your pretty panties. And that's all these folks do to us. They tell us a nice story so they can get between our legs. And you let them. And they don't have to give us nothing except some fancy talk like Kamala Harris did last night. Of course, Oprah Winfrey gonna support Kamala Harris. She's rich. She don't suffer. She's not gonna listen really to what is out here. She's not, because they Taylor Swift, they rich. Beyonce is rich. Jay-Z is rich. But I'm telling you, this reminds me of Hillary Clinton. All the hype. It is my prediction that Donald Trump is going to be your president, because all this hype, all this stuff for Kamala Harris don't mean nothing, because it's all in the hands of the Electoral College. And if there's any type of legitimacy to it all, the Electoral College is going to choose Donald Trump for your president. He cannot do no worse than Joe Biden. He can't do no worse than Ronald Reagan or Jimmy Carter or Gerald Ford or Obama or any of them other suckers. It is in my belief that if Black people, Black Americans, if you got your act together through Donald Trump, because he's unorthodox, he's non-traditional, you can get something out of that president. You're not gonna get nothing out of Kamala Harris. She's nothing but a Joe Biden protege, puppet. You're not gonna get nothing out of her. Donald Trump told you, and it's facts, you don't have nothing to lose. Go look at the history. These Democrats, crats, and these folks ain't doing a damn thing for you. You have nothing to lose. But if you had your act together, instead of all this emotional and the Cinderella delusion mindset that you have, because you're not grown men and women. You're not full functioning men and women. You connected to the hype. I know how you feel. Because when I was a young man, Louis Farrakhan and all those thousands of people, all the hype, I was caught up in all that. Then there was a little guy. There was a little guy in Mississippi with his little money actually was producing things. I didn't want nothing to do with that because I wanted to be part of the hype. But the little man in Mississippi, if you was part of that organization, if you was part of what he was doing, everybody shared in what was being produced. I spent 9 years with Louis Farrakhan and got nothing. I spent 9 years with Louis Farrakhan. The only thing I got was a burnt up bean pie, some throwaway bean pies, and they gave me the privilege of sleeping on pickle barrels. One of the people that listens to this ministry left a comment, small talk. I never knew this about you. I am so sorry, but I am out of here. Why? You never was in here. People don't have a right to their opinion. I don't like you. You only like somebody as long as they can feed your delusion. Why are you going to come to my platform and write, I never knew this about you. I'm so sorry. What you sorry about? But I'm out of here. Tell me what I'm saying wrong. Debunk the things that I'm saying. That's all you got to do. But you can't. You caught up in the hype. You don't like Donald Trump. It's a popularity contest. The presidency is not based upon popularity. And you're going to find out. Because I can almost guarantee this man is going to be your president. This woman, you watched the debate. She did poorly. For those who listen, those who are actually watching, sit back in the cut. And listen and watch. I didn't see no leader from her. She fits this fairy tale Cinderella thing that y'all got going. I can be in error. Come here and talk to us. They're not gonna do that. Every point I made, I want you to show that we are in error. That we're wrong. You can't do it. You're going to have problems. Just like she had problems, she always stayed on the offensive with that man. She don't want to debate him no three times. She barely got away this time. And I want to say this in my conclusion. Something they laughed about. But this is the reality. They laugh at Donald Trump because he made a statement that in this town, Springfield, Ohio, somewhere, I think it's Springfield, Ohio, the immigrants coming in and they eating people's pets. And folks laugh and don't believe that, blah, blah, blah. Okay, this is the reality. This is the reality. The reality is you don't know. You don't believe it, but you really don't know. But this is the reality. You have thousands of people coming across the border. Not a few hundred. You have thousands. Some of them are not connected to no kind of welfare system, or they're not getting enough. So if you're hungry, you're going to eat. And if there's a dog, if there's a cat, if there's a rat that's available, yeah, I'm going to eat it. You don't think like that because you get three square meals a day. So I can't imagine. There was an episode on Good Times back in the 1970s, and this lady was not eating dogs. But she was eating dog food. This was the 1970s. When you're hungry, or rather when you're starving, starving people are going to eat whatever they can find. When you're hungry, I don't want that. I don't eat that. I'm a vegetarian. I don't eat that. When you're starving, I eat dog, I eat cat, I eat rat, I eat some rotten tomatoes, whatever I got to eat. So you have thousands of immigrants coming across the border. Why do you think it's beyond imagination that they're not some of them, and some of them don't care? During the war, during World War II, because of lack of food, folks started eating their horses. Exactly, Nola Man. Folks start eating their horses. That's why when you go to Europe, they will put horse on the menu because they got used to eating horse because of the war. Because I don't have no food. When you're starving, when you're in survival mode, you gonna eat. I don't eat this. And especially, look, you. Exactly. It's called a delicacy now. Exactly. So you live here in this country, and a lot of you are comfortable. You get your three meals a day, you're living good. You don't know what suffering is about. But it's coming to you. You're gonna find out what it is. Believe me, these folks mess around and cause World War III. You're gonna find out the hard way. You're gonna learn that dog tastes good. You're gonna learn that cat tastes good. You're gonna learn that rat tastes good. Some of us gonna learn how human beings taste good. The first Americans became cannibals in this country. Exactly, Nola Man. I did too. I was raised on mayonnaise sandwiches. You're right. Mayonnaise sandwiches and ice cubes, ice water. That's what we had. But see, when you are comfortable, you don't think about these things. You only think about yourself, because I'm comfortable. But what about the people that's not comfortable? What about the people that's suffering? What about the people that did not get justice? You're only thinking about yourself, selfish ass people. We're selfish. So we'll see. Next 8 weeks, we're gonna see how all this comes out. We're gonna see if Kamala Harris gets the presidency. You're gonna see. And believe me, as long as I live and have breath, when your Kamala Harris mess up, cause World War III, I'm gonna be here until the internet cuts off. You damn fool, you was warned, told. This woman ain't no leader. She's being told by these other folks. She don't have no idea. Trump wasn't in a position to really hammer this lady the way she need to be hammered. I will debate her. I would debate a Kamala Harris supporter. I would debate you based on these things that I've already put here. I don't care nothing about the hype. When did she become holy and righteous? That woman is not holy and righteous. She was a prosecutor. Who knows how many innocent people she sent to prison and to death row or cause them to have overpunish our people. I know about prosecutors. I'm a victim. I know how they think. Exactly. I'll be happy to debate any.
I'm not even a politician. I'm talking about on character and integrity. She don't have any character. She has no integrity. Just putting on this show. And she put herself in a position on this debate so that man could not hammer her ass the way she needed to be hammered. She would have failed. She would have failed. The way they set that debate up to protect her from the hammer. Please, hammer. Don't hurt her. Right, exactly. It's all a facade. Just like Nola Man said, it's a facade. So bring it. I would debate the things that I pointed out today. I would debate any Kamala Harris person, anybody. I'm easy to reach. Set the live stream up. Bring it. Got to bring your A game. You're gonna fail. Because you caught up in this fairy tale. She's the worst of two evils. She has no leadership skills at all. You can tell she's a puppet. You can tell they gave her some type of narrative to stay on. I do this for the American people. I love the American people. We cannot let evil, we cannot let the evil Donald Trump. Okay, lady. Okay. But again, I could be wrong. I could be in error. So come teach us and show us our error. I have no problem with that. Because really, I could care less. But if I have to make a choice, she's not better than Donald Trump. I don't see leadership skills in her. But then again, most of y'all follow these people. They're not leaders. They have no vision. They're not creative, a bunch of babbling, feel-good rhetoric, and you do the same thing with the presidency. You follow somebody because they make you feel good. Clearly, this woman is not a leader. Clearly, she can be ran over real easy, just like Obama. Obama was not a leader like that. He let those people just run him over. He wasn't running nothing. The white men in power still ran Obama. And he didn't want to be like Donald Trump, somebody sit in a tree and get shot in the face or whatever. Now, I like somebody, I'm going to say this and get out of here. I like when George Bush was in office. Because George Bush, you limited in your powers as president, but George Bush said, I'm going to do what the hell I want to do. The hell with the Congress. Ronald Reagan did the same thing. Wasn't no punk president. I'm going to send, I will control the army, whether you support them or not. I'm going to send the army to so-and-so. Ronald Reagan wasn't no punk, no pushover. George Bush wasn't no pushover. And even John F. Kennedy, that's why they assassinated John F. Kennedy. Obama, the first black president, he was a pushover. Kamala Harris is going to be a pushover. They don't have no leadership skill. When you become leader, you got to be ready to die for your position. You got to be able to stand on yours. And you can tell this woman, her mannerism, how she talking, she don't even sound strong. She don't sound strong. She sounds weak. Nola Man says, I have no choice, but with Trump, he at least put his up front.
What was it that Malcolm said? Malcolm said he would rather deal with somebody that would be upfront with him rather than these suckers that stab you in the back. Because clearly she's not being upfront. Just look at the mannerism, the talk. Something is wrong. And she lost. She lost the debate simply because she was on the offensive the majority of the time. So she lost the debate. Simple as that. And she don't want to keep debating that man. And she definitely don't want to put herself in a position where he can really hammer her. That's why they don't come to the reality strip on earth, internet ministry. They don't want to deal with me face to face because your ass is going to get hammered. Please hammer, don't hurt him. You're going to get hammered. Because I know all your weak spots. The only thing you can do is run away from me. The only thing that you can say is, I never knew this about you. I am so sorry, but I'm out of here. Like they're supposed to hurt me. You don't do nothing for me. Why do these people subscribe, then they unsubscribe? I'm going to unsubscribe. You ain't do a damn thing for me anyway. You don't do nothing for me. Now, if I had a person that was donating $1,000, $100 a month or something like that, I give you your props. I'm like, wow, why you wanna, you know, why I'm not getting your support no more, blah, blah. I would have concern, maybe. You don't do a damn thing for me. All you do is watch my videos because I'm saying something that feeds your sickness, like JT Riley said. Feed your damn sickness. And then when I bring you to reality, I never knew this about you. I'm so sorry, but I'm out of here. Take your ass on. You never was here to begin with. You was only here to leech off me, whatever I have to bring. You ain't nothing but a damn parasite. You ain't no support of me. These folks. Like they doing you a favor. Don't tell me. Far as I'm concerned, your ass was gone a long time ago. So what? You will not be missed. I don't know why folks do that. If I subscribe to somebody and I don't like them, I just unsubscribe. I don't get on there. I don't like what you said. I'm out of here. I just unsubscribe and go about my business. Then later on, I say, I wonder what so-and-so is doing. I go back and maybe they changed something or done something. I subscribe back to them. I don't go around. I'm mad at you like a little kid. Like a little goofy ass child. I don't like you no more. I never knew this about you. I'm so sorry. I'm out of here. Goofy ass people. Goofy just like Kamala Harris, the way she looked. She lost the debate, whether you like it or not. My prediction, Donald Trump will be president. That's my prediction. Because she don't exhibit somebody with leadership. She don't exhibit to me. I don't see her as a strong figure. I know strong women. And I support womanhood. Everybody that come to my channel know I am pro-female. And I would love, y'all in love with the idea of a female being president. But she's not a leader.
I don't support people simply because to support them, because they black. I love Spike Lee movie, Do the Right Thing. I like Spike Lee movie, Malcolm X. Other than that, I don't do Spike Lee. There's certain things Tyler Perry does I'm cool with. There's certain things that Tyler Perry does I'm not cool with. I don't support folks simply because they black. I support you because you got something I want and you giving out a good product, and I will support you. Not because simply because you black. I can't function on black. I function on that product that you're producing. And see, I don't function on your on YouTube videos. So I'm not going to cash out because you're running your damn mouth. I'm not going to cash out the preachers and the pastors and these YouTube personalities. That don't do a damn thing for me. But that's how y'all roll. Because somebody can make you feel good, but they produce nothing. Exactly. Nola Man says, they selling you dreams, but you have to be asleep to believe it. We're going to say that again. They selling you dreams, but you have to be asleep to believe it. Exactly. Nola Man says that Kamala Harris, she does. She act like a soccer mom. You know, that giggling. She giggling and, you know, looking at Trump, giggling and sniggling. Actually, he said that was his best performance. I really don't watch the man like that. But he was able to keep his composure. He wouldn't do it. I mean, Trump is going to be Trump. But she's there looking at him like a little schoolgirl or whatever. And this is what you're going to have as your president, going to these rough and tough leaders. See, Donald Trump already has dealt with Vladimir Putin. He's already dealt with Zelensky, whatever his damn name is. Donald Trump already been there, done that. He's a man. Many of these people not gonna respect her simply because she's a woman and she's sniggling and giggling. She don't even look like she's tough. She looks like she can easily be manipulated by the other men that's around her, even her husband. I just don't see it. Even some of these pro-blackly black folks, I see them, Kamala Harris. For what? She ain't gave nobody nothing. She didn't do nothing for you as vice president. What did she do for you? What did she stand up and give you and do for you as vice president? So what make you think she gonna give you something as president? We thought that since it was Barack Obama's last term, we thought, oh, now Barack Obama is gonna do something for black folks. He ain't do a damn thing. Because he's part of that system. He's part of the oppressor. He can't do nothing for you. He benefits from the oppression. That's why he lives lavish and rich. Don't give a damn about the poor. These folks don't give a damn about the poor. That's why it was necessary to have a Poor People's March, 1968, I believe. Nobody cares about the poor. Nobody's standing up for the poor. But they can give millions of dollars to the military to go kill folks around the earth. They can give millions of dollars to the police department so they can have military grade weapons. So when your ass rebel, they'll blow you away. And even white people talk about military, what do they call it? Help me with this, Nola. What is it? Military, what do they call it? Military rule. And we almost seen a sign of it during the COVID epidemic. There's a lot of people bunking down right now. They don't know when it's going to happen, but they're getting ready for the worst. Because the leadership, yeah, martial law. Thank you, Nola. Martial law. But see, the poor, you can't bunker down. The poor can't bunker down. All kinds of mayhem. Because see, people gotta eat. And you laughing at Trump, and your happy ass gonna be looking for a dog or a cat or a squirrel. A person who's starving has a different attitude than somebody you get three meals a day. A prediction from the Honorable Elijah Muhammad, and we're gonna get out of here. A prediction from the Honorable Elijah Muhammad, I believe he taught that one day they're gonna open up the prisons and the jails. They're gonna have to let them go. That's the prediction from the Honorable Elijah Muhammad. And these things will happen without proper leadership. And I don't care what you say about Mr. Trump. He can see those things. But Kamala Harris live in a Cinderella fairy tale world. And most of you live there because your belly full. Exactly. Nola says, already did. They coming from other countries. Why are they coming from other countries? Your nation, your government, where Vice President Kamala Harris is part of it, this country purposely destabilizes other nations so they can fall. And when they fall, they run to America. They run to where there's resources. So they come here. They come here because your government done something there that disrupted their nation, and they come swarming here. They don't even stop in Mexico. They come here. What is it that they say in science? In science, for every action, there's an equal and opposite reaction. Whatever we do in life, there's a consequence. If you do something bad, there's a consequence. If you do something good, there's a consequence. There's a reason why these people are coming across these borders. There's a reason. And chances are your government is behind it. They're not going to tell you that. Your government. But see, those of us in the black struggle, those who are part of black conscious, black first, whatever, we already know that. We accept that. They might not agree with me on a lot of things, but we all agree on that. And we're not going to let this country forget its evil against melanated people in this country and around the earth. We should never allow them any rest. Somebody should always tell them who they really are. Goofy ass. With that said, we're going to get out of here. Thank you for listening. Jot down your comments, subscribe. And nobody came to join the conversation. to help me understand better. Because I could be in error. Nola, I could be wrong. I could be wrong. I could be in error. Come and teach me. Come and show me. Don't bring no bull doo-doo. Whatever you bring, it has to pass the criteria of common sense, logic, being analytical, and reason. I'm not about emotion. What makes me feel good? Let's deal with reality, the reality of the situation. And I just do not see this woman, just because I would like to see the first woman president and all like that, that don't, what's the sense of having the first woman president and she takes this nation into World War III? Huh? It defeats the purpose. Thank you, Noah. Subscribe, share, and all that kind of good stuff. Again, everyone, we are simulcasting on Reality's Tip on Earth Internet Ministry Facebook, right here on Reality's Tip on Earth Internet Ministry YouTube channel, Angel Snuffing Up 7 YouTube channel, also Reality's Tip on Earth. That's a lot of simulcasting. And I'm happy that we did not have technical difficulties. We always have a lot of, for me, I don't know what it is, what's happening, but we have a lot of technical difficulties. But so far, the last live streams, everything has been pretty good. So thank you. Thank you, Noah. Thank you. I'm out of here. Thank you for showing up. I'm not what you thought I was, and you out of here. Thank you for showing up. Who cares? The soul train don't stop because folks get off the train somewhere. The soul train keeps the soul train keeps moving on. The soul train been down the track since 2007. You wasn't here in 2007. I've seen them come, I've seen them go. Who gives a damn? You don't do nothing for me except come and listen. Then when you get tired of listening, you take your happy ass on somewhere. Who cares? Woo, 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 woo. The soul train keeps rolling on. And to our new listener, Nola, I would hope that you would investigate and examine our video talking about Operation, where is it? Over here. Operation Exodus Mississippi campaign, the best realistic solution for the problem of Black Soul America. Check it out. Just do a Google search, find any of our videos about Operation Exodus Mississippi campaign. So on that note, we're going to get out of here. And shout out to Nola in Louisiana, those who are in our Facebook. I never forget you. Matter of fact, I might start doing my videos from Facebook. We get more action, more views on Facebook, actually. We get a lot of harassment on YouTube. I don't know why. Get a lot of harassment on YouTube. Shout out to everybody. To those who are listening now and to those who will be listening to this broadcast at a later time, as our ancestor, Don Cornelius, used to always say, as in parting, we wish you love, peace, and soul. And we are Audie 5000. telling you how I look at it.
Wasn't it Democrats, Kamala?
No, you need to get hammered on.
Hammered on.